Hello guys, welcome back to Mighty Good Gaming. I'm Dustin, your host. What's going on guys? How are you guys today? I'm going to do a little video talking about the Xbox One X. It's getting a lot of flack because of the 1 terabyte hard drive it comes with. A lot of people saying that's not enough room with the 4K updates to Xbox's games. And just wanted to talk a little bit about that. I know some people are for it, some people are against it, some people say it should come with more, all that stuff. Just kind of wanted to talk a little bit about it, share my personal feelings about it. A lot of people, you know, they're saying 1 terabyte because of, you know, some of the games like Gears of War takes 103 gigs for an update to that. You know, with the update and everything, it's 103 gigs. They're saying that was too big and all that stuff. The thing is Gears of War, just on the standard edition of Xbox, has a 98 gig installation. So, 98, 99, 100, 100, 1, 2, 3. 5 extra gigs. That's all it takes for the 4K update. 5 extra gigs. So, them saying, oh, it takes 100 gigs. Yeah, but it took almost 100 gigs before that. So, I don't really think that they have room to complain about that. They should have been complaining about that last year when the game came out. I think it was too big of a deal. I think that's too big for a, you know, too big of a download or file size. I'll say it correctly. Too big of a file size to begin with. But Gears is a phenomenal game. I really like it. They were talking about Quantum Break taking a lot of room. I think it took, if you download the show with the game, it took a huge, I think it was like 150 something gigs, 160 gigs, something like that. I can't remember exactly. But I played Quantum Break and I just streamed the show. Most people said, it doesn't work right if you stream it and all that stuff. I don't have fast internet connection at all. And I streamed it no problem. I don't see why you would want to download it. If you do want to download it, I'm sure you can, you know, delete that off there if you want. But, you know, Quantum Break's, I think it came out last year as well. And it's a really good game. I think that the visuals could have definitely been touched up. They try to add a film grain quality to it that just made it look fuzzy. But with on the Xbox One X, with the 4K upgrade and stuff, I know the game actually only had a resolution of like 720. Or, excuse me, not 720. It's like 900p or something like that. It wasn't even full 1080 to begin with. So, you know, for it to get that upgrade and everything, yeah, I mean, it's a big file and stuff. And if you want to download the show and everything, yeah, I could see that being a complaint. But overall, I think a terabyte is a lot of room. I mean, yeah, if you're going to have 20 games on there, you're not going to have room for 20 games. But they do support the external hard drives, which I'm not seeing that the, you know, just the internal terabyte is that big of a deal. I mean, you can get a terabyte hard drive, external hard drive, for like $40. I was looking at one at Walmart for, it was a 4 terabyte, and I think it was like $109, right around the $100 mark for a 4 terabyte. So, I mean, you're already shelling out $500 for the console, which is a decent price for it. I paid $500 for my original Xbox One, so I don't really see that, you know, seeing how much more powerful it is, yeah, I think it's worth it for that. But if they added, like, say they added a 4 terabyte hard drive, that would go from $500 to probably $600 or $650 maybe even. So that's getting in the ballpark of no one's going to buy your console because it's ridiculously priced. So for them to, you know, support the external hard drives and stuff, and the external hard drives are very affordable. You know, just leaving it up to the customer, because you may be a guy that only plays the new Madden game every year, or you maybe only play the new Call of Duty or Forza. I mean, you're not going to need more than a terabyte. Excuse me, guys. I've got the hiccups this morning. You're not going to need more than a terabyte. But if you know, if you're the hardcore gamer and you're going into this and stuff, you're probably going to invest in, you probably may even already have an external hard drive. So I really don't see the issue, because I would much rather buy the Xbox One X and then buy the external hard drive later instead of just shelling out that big, huge lump sum all at once. But that's just my opinion. I know a lot of people, you know, they feel differently about it, and that's mine. But your opinion, I respect that. I'm just stating what my opinion is. I think that a terabyte would be fine. I know a guy that I work with. He has pre-ordered. He got a Scorpio edition of the Xbox One X. I'm not even expecting him to be at work today, but he only plays Destiny. He plays Destiny and Destiny 2. That's his big games. I think Mortal Kombat X as well. But you know, he plays like 3-4 games. And the terabyte hard drive, I asked him about it. He said it was more than enough space, that he's not even going to use probably half of it. So, you know, he was more than happy with it as well. So, but anyway, guys, like I said, this is just my opinion. You know, you may feel differently and stuff. And, you know, I do respect your opinions. And I'm not saying you're wrong, because that's the way you feel. And you are entitled to feel the way you feel. And, you know, a lot of people, they're going to force their opinion. This is the reason that it's correct. No, I'm not going to say that. Because it would be right for me does not mean that it would be right for you. So, and maybe you would be willing to shell out the extra cash for the additional hard drive and stuff. And that would be really cool as well. But anyway, that does it for the video, guys. Hope you like it. Hope you've enjoyed it. I apologize about the lighting. It is crap. It is crappy day weather-wise. It's just rainy and misty, and just a typical fall rainy day here in Washington State. No, I don't live in Washington. I actually live in Kentucky, toward the Tennessee border and Kentucky-Tennessee line area, and it's around Lake Cumberland. If any of you guys know where that's at, it's beautiful here. Very beautiful. We got this huge lake. We got the nice mountains and trees and all that stuff. We can really enjoy during the fall the beautiful colors and all that stuff. But anyway, I'm not getting off on a nature video here. But anyway, guys, that does it for the video. Thank you for all your love, support, suggestions on the other videos. Please keep leaving those. I love reading that stuff, guys. I try to get back to you if I can. If you've not got a chance, check out my other video that I'm going to upload before this one, and it's about my game picks for the week, what I am currently playing. And if you guys have any picks of your own, leave them in the comments on this video, that video, either one. Let me know what you guys are playing, what games, what are your picks for the week, for the month, games you're looking forward to, whatever. Anyway, guys, I'm Dustin. I'm signing out. Peace. Hope you guys have a good one. Behave and all that good stuff. Have a good one.